More than a sternly word.
I sympathize with your frustrations, gentlemen. Ah, Connor. Hello again. What brings you to Boston?
You.
Would you excuse us, fellows? Thank you. That conversation was about to turn unpleasant. Now, what can I do for you?
I was hoping you could help me locate William Johnson.
Of course. I'm headed to a meeting with some men who should be able to help. Why don't you come along? Ah, it's good to see the people finally taking a stand against injustice.
Says the man who owns a slave.
Ooh, sorry? I practice what I preach, my friend. She's not a slave, but a freed woman, at least on paper. Men's minds are not so easily turned. It's a tragedy that for all our progress, still we cling to such barbarism.
Then speak out against it.
We must focus first on defending our rights. When this is done, we'll have the luxury of addressing these other matters.
You speak as though your condition is equal to that of the slaves. It is not.
Tell that to my neighbor who was compelled to quarter British troops, or to my friend whose store was closed because he displeased the crown. The people here are no freer than Surrey.
You offer excuses instead of solutions. All people should be equal, and not in turns.
It's in turns, or not at all. We must compromise, Connor.
Hey! It's my home, no matter what you thieves called taxmen say! If the gumps in Parliament who want to take my property, you tell them to sail across the pond and take it themselves!
It's not open for discussion now! Open this door or these men will break it down!
Ah! Ah, bollocks! We're coming in!
Ah! I trust the mounting evidence is proof enough, Connor.
Continue on. I shall meet you at our destination.
I could use some support! Is that all you have? Is that all you have? You can't take what's not yours!
Justice for once. I dare the governor to send more.
You all right?
I'm fine. It's not my first dance. For all their teeth and claws, these little foxes, they fight like puppies. Thank you, my friend. I'd buy you an ale, but I'm expected somewhere else.
Connor, I'd like you to meet some like-minded friends. The owner of this fine establishment, William Molyneux, and the manager and chef of his newest venture, Stefan Chaffaut.
Ah, Connor and I just had a ball with some redcoats enforcing some taxmen outside my home.
The collectors grow bolder and more forceful. Something we must address, Samuel.
Then let us raise a banner. Something to let the people know that they are not alone. The docks are an angry place of late. Protesters picketing the latest shipments of British tea. The eyes of the city are upon that stage.
A Bostonian without his tea is a dangerous beast.
William Johnson is smuggling the tea off the ships. One of his men tried to sell me this. A sample of what I refused. But it's from those ships. No mistaking the stamp. He's charging a king's ransom. Must be he's making a mint off those who buy it.
Where is he now?
I've never met the man.
May I ask why you seek him, Connor?
He intends to purchase the land upon which my village stands, without the consent of my people.
No doubt the revenue from his little smuggling endeavor is financing the acquisition. A tax enforced on tea grants a boon to smugglers. I'll wager the same men who levy the taxes are selling the tea. A stage requires a spectacle, and I may know the play. Connor, head back to the docks and see to the destruction.
Pardon me.
Oh, come on, mate. Thank you.